Please, no static. Please, 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 no static. Red lips too much? Let a girl know. What's up, everyone? It's your favorite line chick back on your screen with another one. I'm super hyped, probably overhyped to do this video for you today. It's been on my mind for about 6 months, but it's perfect as part of 30 Days of Blind. These are the stages of Stargardt's. Of course, disclaimer, even if we have the same disease, it may express differently. So either physically, you may have better or worse acuity than me, or in your life, it may affect you in different ways. But I figured today we'd focus on the emotional stages of Stargardt's. Of course, you may have gone through these at different stages or different orders or not at all. Let a girl know down below. But I thought it'd be a good thing to talk about since I've been talking to thousands of people with Stargardt's disease over the last couple of years. And we all seem to have similar feelings, except for the first stage. I think that's just a me thing. So let's get into it. So the first stage of Stargardt's disease, as experienced by me, was denial. Because denial is not just a river in Africa. When I first heard that joke, I'm like, har, har, har. But now I use it all the time. So as a lot of you know, if you've been watching my channel for any amount of time, I was diagnosed at 21. So I didn't have the type of time to care about no diagnosis. I had already known that I was probably gonna have Stargardt's disease from when I was about 20, because that's what they were saying when I was 19. But after a year of tests and 7 specialists, yeah, when they said I had Stargardt's disease, it wasn't like I didn't believe them. It was more like, okay, this is light work, I got this. And for the first couple of years, I could handle it. I still had glasses, I was still pretty regular, you know? It wasn't until about my mid-20s that I was like, whoa, what is this? And stage 2 kicked in. So the second stage of Stargardt's disease, say that 3 times fast, for me, was shock and sadness. For a lot of you that reach out to me, whether in the DMs or emails or in the comment sections, this is usually your first stage because you're not like me trying to run away from the truth. Shock and sadness is pretty normal for any type of grief, any loss, any big shift in life. And initially my shock came in the form of like, wait, you mean to tell me that once these glasses stop working, there's nothing for me until I'm blind enough for a dog or a cane? Which fast forward 11 years later, and a dog and a cane is still not a solution for me. So another story for another day. I was just so shocked that there wasn't anything better. I mean, we're in the technological era, aren't we? Meanwhile, there's nothing. I was just like, wait. Hola. You mean to tell me that there's no cure? So what about all the stem cell research you've been doing or gene therapy? I've been reading up on these things. There's no cure for me. I was so confused. And that made me feel so sad, which is the second, like 2.2 of stage 2. I was so sad from the shock of realizing like this is my life, which led to the third stage of Stargardt's disease, which was the loss of the life that I thought I was supposed to have. I say supposed to because it's all about the shoulda, coulda, wouldas. I just figured that my life would be so much better had I not had this disease. And who knows, maybe it would be, or maybe it'd be 10 times worse. It could go both ways, or maybe it'd be exactly the same. Who's to say? But in this third stage, I really felt this sadness for the loss of the life I was supposed to have. Take it from me. I used to be, not so much anymore, a type A person planning everything to a T. Like, you know, I still kind of do it when I go on trips. Like I'll write down my outfits for the day before I go so I don't have to think and I can just swap it if it's a rainy day or a sunny day or whatever. But I was like that about life before. So having a disease just derailed everything. I was blindsided. And because of that, I just couldn't conceptualize life with vision loss. And it was so difficult for me that it became this detachment of me from my disease, but also part of my identity. And it was really hard because that leads to stage 4, which is the worst out of all stages. And that was depression. It's something I wouldn't wish on anybody. I've had 2 bouts of it and I hope to never experience it again. The hardest part about being depressed is the hopelessness. It's feeling like this is your new normal. Every day you wake up and you have no purpose, you have no feeling. You could eat your favorite food and it feels the same as if you ate gruel. Like it doesn't matter. And there's obviously different severities of the expression of depression. And I'm very grateful that I was able to use the tools in my toolkit to get out of it each time. But it's not easy. It's not easy feeling like you're not complete because you're losing your vision. And it's not, you're also in the depression feeling like there's no cure, so there's nothing, there's no hope. It's a terrible feeling. And I'm happy that I don't feel that way about life anymore. I have hope for life. I have hope for a cure. I have hope for things being better than I could have ever imagined. And it just gives me the fuel to keep going on. The fifth stage of Stargardt's disease should actually be the stage, because this is how I feel every day. And that's frustration. Also a little bit of anxiety. So can't lie, I get anxious quite a bit. Not all the time, but sometimes I'll just have these random bouts. I won't call them attacks because I don't like to just throw things out there, you know? But I'll have moments where I'm just freaking out over my computer not working, because it's like, what if this is the biggest I can zoom in, then what? And it's like, just chill. Like, it's not that serious. We've always found a way around things. We got this, girl. And I said it before in other videos, like, losing my vision hasn't been the worst thing that happened to me. So all things considered, I got this. But I still get frustrated on the daily, because either A, I'd be doing things forgetting that I'm blind. Like, girl, why did you pick up that book like you could actually read it? Why are you pretending to read this label in the store? Just take out your phone and zoom in. Like, who are you appeasing? And then B, sometimes I'll do something and in that moment realize that I can't do it anymore and get pissed off. Cause it's like, what the? I could do this yesterday. Like, literally, there are things that within a 24-hour window, my vision's gotten so worse, so much more worse, that I'm just like, whoa, hold on, like, what's going on here? And I get frustrated because it's like, I just figured out a new way to do that, now I have to figure out another new way. It's so annoying. And it's frustration all as well with other people, because I'm the type, let me know if you're this way too, where I will do things to accommodate other people that inconvenience myself. And this is like the worst thing you can do when you're already inconvenienced by an obstacle or limitation. But I'll do something and then like 6 months down the road, I'll tell someone like, yeah, sending me long DMs is not it for me, because I can't see that. Like, zooming in, spending 20 minutes to read your DMs, then voice noting it back to you, that's not it. Just send me a voice note on iMessage. We got our numbers. And then having people kind of be like, oh, but it's been working. It's like, it's degenerative, okay? And I've been trying to make it work for you as long as I could. So now please make it work for me. So there's a lot of frustration. I call it stage 5 because I think the other 4 stages really impacted me in increments, whereas 5 has been more present. It's been present the entire time, but I need to throw it in somewhere, okay? Stage 6 would be, you know, the fluffy stage. This is something that I've been sharing with you a lot recently, and that's gratitude, as well as GPP. So that's gratitude, positivity, and being present. It's so important to enact, enable, enforce. What's wrong with me today? This is the major key. You need to initiate. That sounds so crazy. Once you activate that, you got it, girl. You got it, guy. I'm telling you, I feel so much better. I feel so much more fulfilled in my life, even though that much has changed, because I'm able to be grateful and positive and present and always just bring it back to those 3 simple things every morning, several times a day. Have you seen Inside Out, where the little girl has like the emotions in her head? That's me every day, fighting my emotions, getting pissed off and then telling myself to namaste. Like, trust me, GPP keeps me calm, cool, collected, and grounded. The 7th stage, honestly, I haven't reached yet. This is like the stage of enlightenment that only so many select few may ever reach. That is acceptance. I would say I have accepted it somewhat. Like, if there was a percentage for acceptance, if ever that was a thing, I'd say 25%, which lets you know that I haven't accepted a lot about my eye disease, and it's been 11 years. With acceptance, the more I accept, the more I feel enabled and empowered to express myself, to feel like a fuller sense of myself, and to also just choose to see things differently. When you accept that, yo, this is life, this is what it is now. Even with the pandemic, for example, this is a perfect example. Once you accept that we're living in a pandemic and we can't go back to what life was before, it's easier for you to start to plan and readjust and pivot yourself to better deal with life as it is now, so that you have a better future. If you don't accept, it's going to take you longer. The same way with the first stage of denial, it took me longer to get to every other phase. When you get to the point of starting to accept, because I do believe it's a lifelong process, especially with the degenerative disease that always tries you, it's going to be better, not easier, better for you in the long run. Acceptance is one of those things that I've been fighting so much off camera. I've shared a little bit in the vlogs, but if you only knew. With the other 6 stages, I can see in good ways and not so good ways that this disease has challenged me, but acceptance is, like I said, it's the enlightenment. It's like the thing that only so few who really want to take it up will be able to do. And it's not something you master necessarily, but more of a daily practice. Because I can accept, okay, my vision's like this and be okay with it. But then in 2 weeks, if it gets worse, I have to accept it again. And even not just that, I have to accept that when new people enter my life, I have to be open to how they're going to react to this, or as things change in life with Starburst disease on top of it. It's all acceptance, right? Acceptance is so freaking hard though. It's so hard and I don't want to do it. Sometimes I confuse acceptance with throwing in the white towel. Like, okay, I give up. Stargardt's wins. I know it's not like that, but sometimes I feel that way and I have to shift the perspective and look at it differently. I think once you work on the other six steps and get some clarity with that, the acceptance will come, not easier again. I don't think any of this is easy, but it will be more of a smooth transition to the seventh stage of where you're efforting every single day to accept this piece of you. And if you've accepted it already, can you please give me the tea on how you did that? Because girl needs it. Anywho, I'm gonna wrap the video up here. Again, let me know what you agree and disagree with down below. If you haven't already, share and subscribe. There's a couple more videos to go as part of 30 Days of Blind. And until next time, stay safe, stay sane, stay blessed. Love and later.